Hello to everyone, myself Sridhar Reddy Murthy, lecturer in ECE from Government Institute of Electronics, Secunderabad. Today we are going to learn CIDIN scheme, Electronics and Video Engineering branch. Subject code is 305C and subject name is Network Analysis. So in this subject Network Analysis, we are already in 6th chapter, that is Network Theorems and Resonance. So a few topics which are covered in my last video are, so these are the topics we discussed in the last video. Once again we are going to review those topics, then we will start with new topics in this video lecture. So first of all, we discussed these things in my last video, that is in part 7. The first topic is, we discussed about the resonance in series RLC circuit, and we derived formulas for series resonance circuit, and what are the conditions that are required for series resonance, and we also defined bandwidth of series resonance circuit, and we also derive equation for bandwidth of a series resonance circuit, and also we discussed about lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency, and we derived formula for lower cutoff and upper cutoff of our frequencies. So with the and by using all these theoretical concepts, now we did some problems on series resonance circuit. So actually what is meant by series resonance circuit means, if a series resonance circuit is, a series RLC circuit is satisfied the conditions, any one of these, then that circuit is called as a series resonance circuit. The first condition is here, the total net reactance of the circuit will become zero, then that is series RLC circuit is also called as series resonance RLC circuit. The second condition is, here the unity power factor is provided by the circuit, then the circuit is also called as a series RLC circuit. And the third condition is, the voltage across the inductor is equals to the exactly opposite to the voltage across the capacitor, then that circuit is also called as series RLC circuit, resonance series RLC circuit. And the fourth condition is, if the circuit is behaves like a pure resistive circuit, then that circuit is also called as a pure resistive series RLC resonant circuit. So these are the things we discussed in the last video, and also by using these concepts we will get some problems on series RLC resonant circuits. Now in this video we are going to learn these topics. So the first topic is here. Now we are going to do some more problems on series resonance circuit. After that, now we will move to the next one, that is resonance in parallel circuit. And similarly, what are the conditions required for parallel resonance circuit? And we are going to derive equation for resonant frequency. After that, now we are going to compare series and parallel resonance circuits. By using this parallel resonance concept, now we are going to solve some simple problems on parallel resonance. And the last topic is, in this video lecture, what is the effect of resistance on bandwidth? So these are the topics now I am going to cover in this video lecture. I hope everybody following my lecture. So in that, the first one is what is the first topic in today's video lecture here? So now we are going to do some simple problems on series resonance circuit. Now consider here, why again I am discussing problems on series resonance circuit means, yesterday we did some three problems. The complexity level of those three problems are very low. Now I am going to increasing the complexity little bit more. So that's why again I'm explaining these examples in this video lecture.
Mm-hmm.
In that, the first example here, a series RLC circuit with resistance value of R equals to 25 ohms and inductance L equals to 0.6 Henry, resulting in a leading phase angle of 60 degrees at a frequency with the circuit to be resonance. Means now we are going to find here the resonant frequency. Here again go through, read the example once again. So based on given data, based on the data presented in the question, I am going to write the given data in the solution. So the first thing is the given resistance value, that is 25 ohms, and they also mentioned inductance value, that is equals to 0.6 Henry, and also here then given frequency as 40 Hz and phase angle, leading phase angle is nothing but pi, they given as 60 degrees. So the operating frequency they mentioned here in the circuit, here I am considering as 40 Hz. So to find the angular frequency, that is omega. So what is the general formula of omega? 2 pi f. So I am substituting 2 pi and f values. I got here angular frequency value. And to find the capacitance value here, they given only resistance and inductance value. We should find the capacitance value, because the circuit is a series RLC circuit. So by using that capacitance value, now I am going to derive the value of resonant frequency, because resonant frequency formula generally depends on 1 by 2 pi under root LC. In this formula we know the values of 2 pi L, we don't know the value of C. Now let's find the C value first. So that's why in step 2 I am going to find the capacitance value here. We know that for frequencies less than F0, the capacitive reactance is greater than inductive reactance, and the current leads the applied voltage by pi degrees. So then what is the general phase angle formula here? Capacitive reactance is going to be greater than inductive reactance, then phase angle formula will become pi equals to tan inverse XC minus XL by R. Now I know the here I want here XC value. So to find the XC value or C value, now I am taking this tan into the left hand side. So otherwise we can apply tan on both sides, then tan pi equals to tan and tan inverse both are going to be 1, and x is nothing but 1 by c omega c, xl is nothing but omega l divided by r. Now I know the all the values except c value. Now I am substituting all the values in this expression. So the pi value they are given as 60 degrees. And omega value just now we got here 251.32, and we don't know the C value, so I keep it as same as C value here, and remaining omega XCLR, XL is nothing but omega L, another omega value and L value. Similarly another R value substituted here. Now I am going to simplifying by left hand side terms and right hand side terms. So I am rearranging this expression. I want C value, so I am keeping C here only. I am taking this value to the left side. So finally I get like this. So I am adding these two quantities. I got 194.093. So from this I want C value. I am taking C into the left side and this value to the right side. Then it will become, then it will comes to the denominator, and the C will goes to the numerator. So finally we got C value as 2.05 × 10⁻⁵. Now I am going to write it in terms of either micro R, pico R, nanofarads. So it is very near to the microfarads, so that's why I am adjusting these decimal values or decimal points. So then finally C value will become 20.5 × 10⁻⁶ farads or 20.5 microfarads. So I got the C value. Now they asked us to find the at what frequency the circuit is to be resonant. Means now we are going to find the resonant frequency formula F0. What is the generalized expression for F0? 1 by 2 pi under root LC. I know the value of 2 pi, L and C values. Just now, L value are directly mentioned in the problem. That is 0.6. And C value, just now we derived the C value. That is 20.5 into 10 power minus 6. I substituted in this expression. Finally, after simplification, so F naught value, that is resonant frequency, here we got it as 45.38 Hz. Means at this frequency, the series RLC circuit will become resonant and acts as a pure resistive circuit. So this is the way we should find the unknown quantities mentioned in the problem. I think I hope everybody understood. Once if we know the concept and know the formulas, then we can easily find. Let us consider the practical case of coil in parallel with capacitor. So, as shown in figure, note that resistance R represents the coil resistance. Here, consider inductor and capacitor both are connected in parallel across an AC voltage source V. So, here, instead of considering L as the ideal value, L contains consider inductance as a real value, means here are practical, means internally the coil having resistance, here that coil resistance is denoted by R, means here this resistance is going to be presented on the coil winding, presented in the coil winding. So that's why these are resistance is represented in series with the inductor or coil. So consider the circuit like this. So this inductor and capacitor both are connected across an AC voltage source in parallel. Now due to this voltage source, a current is started flowing through the circuit, alternate current, and this current moved to up to here. At this point the current having two paths and it is divided into two currents, that is IL current or inductive current and capacitive currents. And again, the current which is flowing through the inductance path or inductor element, that current should be treated as IL. The current is which is flowing through the capacitive element, that current we should treat it as capacitive current, and both the currents again meet it up to some point and finally it will become the total input current I and reaches to the or sink at the again voltage source. So this is the explanation of this diagram here. And the phasor diagram for this circuit with applied voltage as reference phasor as shown in below figure. So the current drawn by the inductive branch lags behind the applied voltage by an angle of pi L. The current drawn by the capacitive branch leads the applied voltage by 90 degrees. Means first I am going to draw the phasor diagram for this parallel resonance circuit. So if I draw the parallel resonance circuit, this is the general expression, the general phasor diagram of a parallel resonance circuit. So in this, here this applied voltage we are taken as, because in parallel circuit applied voltage should be considered as a reference axis, that is voltage V. And here, if you see the first point, that is the current run by the inductive branch lags the behind the applied voltage by an angle of pi degrees. If you see this inductive current vector, this inductive current vector is going to be lags behind the applied voltage by pi L, and the current through the capacitive branch is going to be leads by 90 degrees with the applied voltage. So that is the meaning of this sentence. And the parallel RLC circuit is said to be in electrical resonance when the reactive component of the circuit becomes zero. We already discussed the net reactance of the circuit becomes zero, then the circuit is said to be a resonant circuit. That condition is applicable whether it is in series or a parallel circuit. Means the same condition we are adopting here. So the frequency at which this condition is going to be happens, then it is called a resonant frequency. From the figure, it is clear that the net reactive components of the circuit current is given by IC minus IL sin pi L. So therefore, the circuit will be resonant at when IC, the total capacitive current, will become equal to the inductive current into sin pi L. Just if you observe this diagram, so we need the total current. Resonant circuit. So that's the meaning of these two sentences. So at resonance, the net reactance will become zero and the circuit will act as a pure resistor. Sir. These paragraphs. Now, what are the salient features of parallel resonance circuits? The first feature is reactive or wattage components of current should be zero. Means the current which is flowing through the reactive component should be zero. The second point is the admittance is equal to the conductance, because the circuit in the circuit, parallel resonance circuit, the net reactance will be zero, only resistor is presented. So that's why that admittance is equal to the only impedance will become resistance, then admittance will become conductance. So that is the meaning of this sentence. The next property or feature is the dynamic impedance is given by L by CR and it is purely resistive and maximum in magnitude. And the line current is minimum and is equal to current equals to V by Z. So the dynamic impedance already we discussed here, L by CR, Z I am replacing the L by CR. And it is in phase with the applied voltage. For any series or parallel resonance circuit, the power factor should be unity. And the next point is, parallel resonance is also known as anti-resonance circuit. The next point is, it is also known as current resonance, because current between the branches is many times the line current. So, the last point here, the circuit at resonance is also called as rejector circuit, or because at resonant frequency the line current is almost or it almost rejects it. Means a parallel circuit, simply parallel resonant circuit will act as a frequency rejector circuit. Means it simply acts as a filter that will remove a particular frequency. So that is the meaning of this eighth feature. If you want to remove a particular frequency, so you can use that values of L and C. So we can remove that particular frequency. The ninth point is here, the circuit at resonance is also called as susceptance curve crosses the frequency axis is called as frequency resonant frequency. Now we will discuss some conditions. What are the conditions required for parallel resonance? So, a parallel RLC circuit is said to be in electrical resonance when any one of the following conditions is fulfilled. The first condition is the net reactant components of the circuit current is zero. We already discussed the current which is flowing through the reactive component, that is IC or IL, will become zero. So IC and IL become zero, then the circuit is said to be parallel resonance circuit. The second one is the net susceptance part of the admittance of the circuit should be equals to
0.
Like this condition is exactly opposite to the condition presented in the series resonance circuit. That is, in the series resonance circuit, the net reactance part of the impedance of the circuit is equals to 0 in series resonance. But in parallel resonance, in the place of reactance opposite is here susceptance, means the net susceptance, it is denoted by B, and part of the admittance, it is denoted by Y of the circuit is equals to 0. The third condition here, the applied voltage is going to be in phase with the resulting current. So this is the one more condition for series resonance, parallel resonance. And the last condition is here, the power factor of the entire circuit is unity, then the circuit is said to be a parallel resonance circuit. I think these conditions are same as our series resonance circuit, but quite opposite. Here, in series resonance, we should consider impedance and reactances, but whereas in parallel resonance, we should consider admittances and susceptances. Now, we are going to discuss the next topic is here. I am going to derive equation of resonant frequency for this parallel resonance circuit. So that can be derived by in two methods. First, before derivation, we should know about the phasor diagram of this parallel resonance circuit. We already drawn the phasor diagram for this parallel resonance circuit. While drawing phasor diagram for parallel circuit, we should consider a voltage vector as reference vector, and we should draw the remaining quantities. And here we already know how to draw the phasor diagram. We discussed in our chapter 1 and chapter 2. So I drawn with the concept. Now I am going to derive the equation in two formats or two methods. Now consider the first method. Consider the parallel RLC resonance circuit as shown in figure. We already know that. And we know that at resonance, the net reactive component of the circuit current is 0 at resonance. The condition is here, the net reactive component of current should be 0 at resonance. That means IC equals to IL into sin pi L. Now, from this, what is Z in Z general value here? Z is nothing but it consists of resistance and reactance. Thank you. means the resonant frequency is going to be same as, this expression is same as series resonant frequency. Resonant frequency means if R is considered as negligible, then it will become equal to the series resonance formula. I think, I hope everybody understood how we got this resonance, series resonant frequency, parallel resonant frequency expression. Now, this is the way of getting resonant frequency in one method. Now, I am going to solve or derive expression for resonant frequency in another method. So, the other method here I have shown in, now I am going to derive expression for resonant frequency in the second. Here, consider series RLC circuit. I have shown in figure, already we discussed about this figure. From that figure, the total admittance of L and branches containing inductor and resistor is given by, so this is the total admittance of inductive branch. In inductive branch, resistor and capacitive inductive reactance are both are connected in series. This is the impedance, then I want admittance, that is 1 by YL equals to 1 by ZL or ZL value equals to R plus JXL. Now I want to minimize this expression, so I'm going to divide and multiply the same with its complex conjugate term, that is R minus JXL by, then I will get R minus JXL by R square plus XL square. So finally, if I further simplifying this, R minus J omega L divided by R square plus omega square L square. So assume this is the equation 1. Now similarly, the admittance of the branch containing C is given by, the C branch admittance is given by 1 by generally XC or 1 by J omega C, then we will get J omega C. Now the total admittance of the parallel circuit is given by Y equals to YL plus YC. Then I am adding equation 1 and equation 2 expression. So this is the equation 1, this is the equation 2. Now further I am simplifying the this total admittance term. So if I take the imaginary parts as common, then I will get here one is real term and one is imaginary term of our total admittance. So but at resonant frequency, we know that what is the condition for resonant frequency? The net susceptance or the net reactance or imaginary part of the total impedance should be zero. Means whatever J part is presented in the above expression, if this part of J part of this expression will become zero, at that the resonant the resonant frequency will presented. Means I am taking the reactant, J part of the equation, that is omega naught C minus omega naught L by R square plus omega naught square L square equals to 0. Means I am taking this imaginary part and equating to 0. So instead of considering omega, I am considering here omega naught, because at that point arranging all these things, so finally I got here F0 equals to 1 by 2 by under root 1 by LC minus R square and by L square. Again here F0 is nothing but resonant frequency. Similarly, so this is the expression when inductance contains here inductor coil having if any resistance, this is the resonant frequency expression. Suppose if inductor having wire having no resistance, means we can neglect this R term in the expression. So finally we got resonant frequency expression as 1 by 2 pi under root LC. So this is expression is looks like similar to the series resonance expression. So means the resonant condition for series and parallel circuits are same. Now I'm going, after finding resonant frequency of a parallel RLC circuit, Now I'm going to find the impedance and current values. I'm going to find the impedance at resonance in a parallel circuit. So the impedance at a resonance is generally denoted by Z0. It is equal to 1 by Y0. The admittance Y0 already we know that. So by putting the real part of the expression is equals to 0, that is R by, if you see the total admittance formula, so this total admittance, this is real part and this is imaginary part. At the real part we will get the impedance at resonance, only real part is presented, so that's why Y0 equals to R by R square plus omega naught square L square. So I want Z0 impedance, that's why Z0 is nothing but 1 by Y0. Y0 we know that 1 by Y0 is nothing but, if I take reverse of this term, so finally we will get Z0 equals to R square plus omega naught square L square by R. But from the equation 4 here, this is the expression for R square omega naught square L square is nothing but L by C. Now I am going to substitute R square plus omega naught square L square is nothing but L by C in this numerator. Then I will get Z0 equals to L by CR. So this is the dynamic impedance formula. It should be noted that the impedance at resonance is resistive only. Since current is minimum at resonance, because in parallel resonance circuit the current should be is minimum, and L by CR must be therefore represents the maximum impedance of the circuit, because at maximum impedance minimum current will flow. So that's why this impedance value should get, we are getting here maximum value. In fact, parallel resonance is a condition of maximum impedance or minimum admittance. I think everybody following this derivation. So after getting Z0 expression, that is impedance at resonance, now I am going to derive current at resonance. It is denoted by I0. So we know that what is the generalized formula for current by using Ohm's law, I equals V by Z. Here we are finding current at resonance, so that's why I become I0 and V by Z becomes Z0. So we know that Z0 value, just now we derived, we got the expression from equation 8, that is V by L by CR. Then the current at resonance we got here, I0 equals to VCR by L. So this is the way we should obtain the parameters of a parallel RLC resonant circuit. I hope everybody understood these concepts of a parallel RLC resonant circuit. Now I am going to compare series and parallel resonant circuit. Okay, once again I am going to review the two topics at a time. If you see here, comparison table. This table comprises of four columns. That is, the first column is serial number, the second column is particular or parameter, the third parameter is series of the circuit, and the fourth parameter is parallel circuit. So now in the first serial number one, I am going to compare these series and parallel resonance circuits with its circuit diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. In this, resistor, inductor and capacitor all are connected in series across an AC voltage source V in series RLC circuit. In parallel resonance circuit, here inductor and capacitor both are connected across a supply voltage V in parallel with each other. But here it is inductor having some internal resistance, that is denoted separately in series with this inductor L. Now the second condition here, the second parameter I am comparing series and parallel resonance circuits, that is impedance at resonance. For a series RLC circuit, impedance at resonance should have minimum resistance or minimum impedance, that Z0 equals to R. In parallel circuit, the impedance should be at resonance, it having maximum impedance, that is Z0 equals to L by CR. Now current at resonance for a series RLC circuit, current should be maximum, that is V0 by V by R. In the case of parallel, the current should be minimum, that is I0 equals to V by Z0. Now similarly, the power factor at resonance in the both the cases, series and parallel, if not unity and unity, and the expression for resonance frequency f not equals to 1 by 2 pi under root LC for a series resonance circuit, and for parallel resonance circuit 1 by 2 pi under root 1 by LC minus R square by L square. If R is absent in this circuit parallel, then the expression for resonance frequency for the both the circuit is same. Now, when the frequency, applied frequency is less than resonant frequency, then the circuit is acts as a capacitive, the series resonant circuit, and the parallel circuit is acts as a inductive circuit. When the operating frequency is greater than resonant frequency, then series RLC circuit is acts as inductive, and the parallel RLC circuit is acts as a capacitive. And the quality factor of the both the circuits will be same, and at resonance, the voltage across the inductor and the voltage across the capacitor both are equal. Similarly, in series resonance circuit, in parallel resonance circuit, the current across the current through the inductor branch and the current through the capacitive branch both are equal. And in magnification, it will magnify the voltage in applied voltage and it will magnify the current. So, this series RLC circuit is also known as frequency acceptor circuit. This parallel circuit is also called as current rejector circuit. These are the comparisons presented between series and parallel resonance circuits. So, with these concepts, now I am going to solve some simple problems on this parallel resonance circuit. So, consider the first example here. In the parallel resonance circuit shown in the figure, find the resonant frequency. So means an inductor is it is consist of some winding. So this winding having internal resistance that is 7 ohm and the inductance value of 1 milli henry, and it is connected in parallel with a capacitor of 20 microfarad. Assume this is a parallel RLC circuit. Now for this circuit, I am going to find the resonant frequency. If it contains its internal resistance, the formula will become resonant frequency formula 1 by 2 pi under root 1 by LC minus R square L square. So from the question, from the diagram, we have R and L and RLC values. So we know the all the values, unknown quantities, that is RLC. In this expression, so what is the unknown quantity presented in this expression? F naught. So after minimizing all these things, that is after substituting RLC values in this expression, so we got resonant frequency as 157 Hz. Means at this frequency, so this parallel RLC circuit will act as a resonant circuit. Or the current through the inductive branch equals to the current through the capacitive branch. Now consider another example. For the tan circuit shown in figure, find the resonant frequency. Similarly, this looks like parallel resonant circuit. An RL are in series and it is parallel with this capacitor, and it is L and C elements are again parallel with the applied voltage. It looks like a parallel RLC circuit. Again, the formula is same for resonant frequency. So, 1 by 2 pi under root, 1 by LC minus R square by L square. From the diagram, we know the LC R values. I am substituted in this expression. So, here micro means 10 power minus 6. After substituting and minimizing these values, finally we got resonant frequency as 1562.94 Hz. Means at this frequency, the circuit will become acts as a parallel resonance circuit. And now the last topic of in this subject and in this chapter is explain the effect of resistance on bandwidth. Because here we are considering the resistance, inductor having some internal resistance R. If I consider R value, then how it going to be affect the bandwidth? So that's why this R term is going to be important. in series and parallel resonance circuits. See here, the generalized bandwidth expression for both series and parallel circuit is given by bandwidth equals to R by 2 pi L, means bandwidth is directly proportional to the resistance. From the above expression, it is clear from the above expression, the bandwidth of a resonant circuit is directly proportional to the resistance of the circuit. That is, if I increase the resistance, then the bandwidth is going to be increases. If I decrease the resistance, the bandwidth is going to be decreases. So, if I draw the graph between the band frequency versus current, so the generally current is going to be depends on resistance value. If R is very large, current will be minimum. If R is very small, the current is going to be maximum. And if R is medium, the current is going to be medium. So the graphs, curves we get like this. If R is very small, then we get at particular frequency, here the current is going to be flows maximum. Here the bandwidth of the circuit is going to be decreases. Similarly, if R is very large, the bandwidth of the circuit is going to be increases. So means, it can be seen that the value of R not only affects the value of the circuit current I, but also affects the shape of the resonant curve itself. For lower values of R, the sides of the curve are very steep, which means the current falls off very rapidly as frequency changes from resonance to half frequency values. Just now we discussed from the figure how the current is going to be affected by varying the R values and how the bandwidth is going to be affected while changing the R values for lower values of R and for higher values of R. So these are the graphs for lower values and higher values of R, or for different values of R. I think I hope everybody understood how it going to be affected the bandwidth for a series and parallel resonance circuits. Now, these are the topics we discussed in this video. I think these topics are everybody understood. I hope. Once again, I am going to review the today's topics. So we discussed about we did some problems on series resonance circuit, and we discussed about series parallel resonance circuit, and what are the conditions required for the parallel resonance circuit. We derived the expression for parallel resonance circuit in two methods, and also we compared the series and parallel resonance circuits by using different parameters. We did some problems on parallel resonance circuit, and the last topic we discussed in the video lecture, what is the effect of resistance on bandwidth. So these are the topics I covered in this video lecture. I hope everybody understood and followed my lecture. Thank you for watching this video lecture. Thank you.